You must be very No.
Get to work! Dumpy Emma, to work!
Kiss one in your bricks.
little girl. Come here.
Yes, officer?
That dog there. Ain't I seen him running around the neighborhood? Ain't he a stray?
A stray? Oh, no, officer. He's my dog.
Your dog, huh? Okay, what's his name?
His name? His name is Sandy. Right, that's it. Sandy. Call him Sandy, see, because of his nice sandy color.
Sandy color, huh? Okay, let's see him answer to his name then.
Answer? You mean when I call him?
Right. When you call him by his name, Sandy.
Well, you see, officer, I just got him.
Call him.
Okay. Here, boy. Here, Sandy. Sandy, here, boy.
Well, maybe he is your dog, but next time you take him out, I want to see him on a leash with a license, or else he's going to the dog and they're going to put him to sleep. You understand?
Yes, officer, I understand. On a leash and with a license.
All right, now get out of here before you catch your death of cold in this weather.
Oh, I don't mind the weather.
Thank you.
All right, move along. All you bums out.
Once again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove for herself what so many women long to prove, that because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over, that romance can live in life at 35 and after.
Oh, merciful God! I hope so!
Yeah?
Good afternoon. Miss Hannigan?
Yeah?
Uncle 17 Precinct. We found your runaway. You!
Thanks so much, officer.
Yeah, she was in one of them Hooverbills down by the docks. Had a mangy mutt with her, but it got away.
Oh, poor pumpkin. Out in the freezing cold with just this thin sweater. I hope you didn't catch influenza. Thanks so much, officer.
All in the line of duty. And you, don't let me ever hear you running away again from this nice lady.
See something that's...
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, officer. Now, I'm gonna have your head. And the next time you walk out that door, it'll be 1953. Well, are you glad to be back, huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar. What's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie. Well, what's the one thing I always taught you?
Never tell a lie, Miss Hannigan.
For what you done, I could get fired. Have the border warden sticking their nose in here. Well, you'll pay for it. I promise. Stay. Yeah?
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yeah?
Oh, good. I'm Grace Fell.
So?
The New York City Board of Orphans...
Wait, hold it. I can explain everything. It wasn't my fault. It was Annie here. You see, who got into Bundle's laundry cart, and I know what she called Mr. Donatella instead of the
cops. Miss Hannigan, I haven't the slightest idea what you're talking about.
Wait a minute. Hold it, sister. If it's beauty products you're peddling, I don't need any. Get out.
Miss Hannigan, I am not peddling anything. I'm private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
Oliver Warbucks? The Oliver Warbucks?
The Oliver Warbucks.
Oh, love the hat. I read in Winchell's column that Oliver Warbucks is the world's richest unmarried man.
I wouldn't know. I don't read Mr. Winchell. Miss Hannigan, Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays at his home.
An orphan?
Yes, an orphan.
You sure he wouldn't rather have a lady? I got 2 weeks coming. It's a joke. What sort of orphan did you have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi, capital MISSISSIPPI, Mississippi.
And cheerful.
You, shut up! And how old?
Oh, age doesn't really matter. Say, 8 or 9. 10. 11. Oh, yes. 11 would be perfect. Oh, and oh, I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers red-headed children.
11. A redhead. No, I'm afraid we don't have any orphans like that around here.
What about this child right here?
Annie? Oh, no. You wouldn't want her. She's a drunk. And a liar. A drunk and a liar.
Yes, I'm sure she's a drunk and a liar. Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' house?
I would love to. I would really love to.
Hold it. You can have any orphan in the orphanage, but not Annie.
Why?
I just told you. She's a drunk and a liar.
I assume, Miss Hannigan, that this has something to do with all that business about the laundry bag and the police. Perhaps I should call Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Orphans. Sign it.
I'll sign it. I'm an easy gal to get along with. If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you get.
It's Annie I want.
It's Annie you get.
I'm full.
So, if you'll get her coat, I'll take her along right now.
Coat? She didn't have no coat.
All right. Then we'll buy her one.
Oh, boy.
Come along, dear. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is waiting outside.
Oh, great.
hardly believe it. Good day, Miss Henry.
Yeah, good day.
Bye, kids.
And season's greetings.
Yeah, season's greetings.
Someday I'll land in that house with all the nuts in the squirrels. There I'll stay tucked away till the prohibition of fleets
first.
Has a painting arrived from Paris?
Yes, sir. They're just about to hang it now, sir.
No, I don't think so. Grace.
Yes, sir.
Messages.
Yes, sir. President Roosevelt. He wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll get back to him tomorrow. Anyone else?
John D. Rockefeller, Mahatma Gandhi, and Harpo Marx.
Nothing urgent. What did Harpo want?
He didn't say.
Wait a minute. Hold on. There is something interesting about that woman's smile. Hang it in the bathroom.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and Mrs. Pugh.
New England's Claire Chowder.
I won't be having dinner tonight. I've got far too much paperwork to get through.
Wonderful.
Grace, I'll need your meditation.
Yes, sir.
It's good to see you again.
Thank you, sir.
Drake, you're dismissed.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Grace, go get your notebook. Who is that?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks. The orphan will be with us for the Christmas holidays.
The orphan? That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan. So I chose a girl.
Oh. Well, I suppose she'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
Sir?
What's your last name, child?
Well, I'm Annie, sir, Mr. Warbucks. I don't have a last name that I know.
So you're just Annie, huh?
Just Annie. I'm sorry that I'm not a boy.
I don't suppose you'd like to meet Babe Ruth.
Oh, boy, sure!
I couldn't be happier that you're spending Christmas with us. Now, Grace, if you'll get your notebook, we'll begin with the figures on the iron ore shipment from Chalipa. What are we supposed to do with this child?
It's my first night here, sir.
It is. Oh. Well, Annie, it's your first night. I suppose we ought to do something special for you. Why don't you sit down, Annie? Would you like to go to a movie?
Yeah, sure, but I'd love to. I mean, I heard a lot about them, but I've never been to them.
Never?
Nope, sir.
Well, we must do something about that right away. And only the best for you, Annie. You'll go to the Roxy. And then an ice cream soda at Rumpelmeyer's and a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Golly!
Grace, forget about the dictation. We can do it in the morning.
Yes, sir.
Instead, you'll take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Something the matter, Annie?
Oh, nothing, sir. Just... Auntie.
No, child, speak up. What is it? You don't want to go to the Roxy?
No, I do. It's just that you are going to do
it. I'm afraid I'll be far too busy for that tonight.
Auntie.
You see, Annie, I've been away for 6 weeks, making an inspection tour of my factories. Oh, what's left of my factories with this damn depression. And when a man is running a multi-billion dollar corporation like I am...
Mr. Warbucks. I understand.
Excuse me, sir. Bernard Baruch calling.
Good. Hello. Yes, Barney, I got in an hour. No, Detroit and Chicago. Barney, I don't like what I saw out there. Factories shut down? My factories. You're damned... You're darn tootin'. When I'm not making money, no one is. And... Gosh darn it, Barney. Your pal Roosevelt's got to do something drastic. He's got to come up with a new approach, a new plan, a new something. Yes, I know he's a Democrat, but he's a human being, too. All right, I'll talk to you about it. If you come over here tonight, we can go over the figures on the... Yes, I'm sorry. Come over here tonight, and I'll show you the plans. Barney? Barney, make it tomorrow. Tonight I've got a date to go to the movies with a 10-year-old girl.
11!
I'm mistaken, Barney. She's 11. Come on. Drake?
Yes, sir?
Coates?
Yes, sir.
Grace? You'll come too, of course.
Yes, sir.
Will you be wanting the Bentley, sir, or the Duesenberg?
The Duesenberg.
Excellent choice, sir.
No, wait! This child's been cooped up in an orphanage too long. No Duesenberg. No walk.
Walk to the Roxy?
Why not? It's only 45 blocks. Smell that. Marvelous. Fifth Avenue Crossing. Their There's no air like the air of New York. You don't realize how much you miss it. The whole damn city until you've been away for a while. It's just like the man says, after New York, every place else is original. NYC, what is this about you? You're big, you're loud, you're tough. NYC, I go years without you, and I can't get enough. Enough of cab drivers entering back in language far from pure. Enough of prank murders answering back. Brother, you know you're in NYC. Too busy, too crazy. Too hot, too cold, too late.
daughter, Faye, is going to marry Carl Michael. On Friday, Carl went back to Chicago.
Oh, Carl!
But no
sooner
had Carl left town than Dr. Andrew came to call on Faye.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Oh, yeah, Farrell. You're early. Only 1 week. What's the matter? Poor Buck's fed up with Annie already.
Oh, no. On the contrary. Mr. Warbucks is delighted with Annie, and Annie is having the time of her life.
How nice.
Oh, yes. She and Mr. Warbucks are practically inseparable. They go everywhere together. To the Roxy, to the Stock Exchange, and, oh, guess where they had lunch yesterday?
The Waldorf.
The Automat.
The Automat?
And she just loves her new coat. She never takes it off.
Never?
Never. I know you're busy, Miss Hannigan, but this has to be signed and sent back. Donatelli, at the Board of Orphans, by no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that guess what?
What?
He wants to adopt her.
How nice. How wonderful. Now let me get this wonderful news straight. Annie is going to be Warbucks' kid. The daughter of a millionaire.
Oh, no, 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 no. The daughter of a billionaire.
A billionaire?
And Mr. Warbucks asked me to stop by in person to tell you that Annie won't be coming back here ever.
Ever? Would you excuse me for one moment, please?
No, see.
Oh, God, Rooster! It never rains, but it pours. They finally let you out of Sing Sing.
Oh, no, no. I got 6 months off for good behavior.
I'll bet. What was it this time?
Some old geezer from Yonkers said I swindled him out of $1,100.
Oh, yeah? Why'd you say that?
Because the Rooster swindled him out of $1,100.
Little.
It's true.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine from
Jersey City.
Jersey City. Miss Lily. Saint Regis.
Named after the hotel.
Oh yeah. Which floor?
Say, sis, don't you just love Lily?
Oh yeah. I'm nuts about her. Rooster, do me a favor.
Anything.
Get out of here and take the St. Regis with you.
Sis.
Can it. Looking for another handout, huh?
No, it's not like that. I got $80 coming in the mail Thursday. But all I need is a 10 to tide me over.
Huh. Not even a nickel for the subway, Rooster.
A fiver, Aggie?
I got to laugh. $5. Oh, God. You, with all your big talk. Gonna be living in clover.
Well, hey, this ain't exactly Buckingham Palace.
Oh, yeah? I'm in the city. Steady salary, free food, free gas and electric. I'm doing all right.
Sis, you're doing like I'm doing.
Lousy.
Lousy. How did the two Hannigan kids ever come to this? On the skids. I remember the way our sainted mother would sit and croon us her lullaby.
She'd say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing from the rule book. Yes. Yes, Mr. President, I will grant you that Barney Baruch and I are not exactly standing on bread lines yet. No, I'm not asking you for your help. I never asked any man for his help, and I never will. I'm telling you that you had better do something and do it damn fast. Fine. We'll talk about it on...
Friday.
All right, Friday at the White House. Goodbye, Mr. President. Listen, why don't we bury the hatchet and you come here with Mrs. Roosevelt on Christmas Eve for supper on your way to Hyde Park? Good. I'm delighted. Goodbye, Mr. President. If I thought he was going to say yes, I never would have asked. Grace, call Al Smith and find out what Democrat sees.
Yes, sir.
The package from Tiffany's.
Yes, sir. It arrived this morning.
Fine. Let me give this thing to her and tell her I want to adopt her. Where is Anne?
She's upstairs in her room, sir, writing another letter to her friends at the orphanage. I'll have Drake call her.
Fine. Damn.
You don't have to be nervous, sir. She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Damn right she is. I'm not nervous. Get her down.
Yes, sir. Drake? Mr. Warbucks will see Annie now.
Miss Annie, Mr. Warbucks will see you now.
Thank you, Mr. Drake. Hello.
Hello, Annie. How are you today?
Fine, thank you, sir. How are you?
Fine. 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 Annie, the time has come for the two of us to have a very serious discussion.
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Annie. Can we have a man-to-man talk?
Sure.
I was born into a very poor family in what they call Hell's Kitchen, right here in New York. Both of my parents died before I was 10, and I made a promise to myself that someday, one way or another, I was going to be rich, very rich.
That was a good idea.
By the time I was 23, I made my first million, and in 10 years, I turned it into 100 million. Boy, those days, that was a lot of money. Anyway, the only thing I've ever given a damn about is making money. I might as well tell you, Annie, I was ruthless to those people I had to climb over to get to the top, because I always believed one thing. You don't have to be nice to the people you meet on your way up. You're not coming back to them. But lately, I've realized something. It doesn't matter how many Rembrandts or Duesenbergs you have. If you have no one to share your life with, if you're all alone, then you might as well be broke and back in Hell's Kitchen. You understand what I'm trying to tell you?
Sure!
Good.
Kind of.
Kind of?
I guess not.
Damn. Annie, I was in Tiffany's yesterday and I picked up this thing for you.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbucks. You're so nice to me.
I had it engraved.
Oh, gee.
It's a silver locket, Annie. I noticed that old broken one you always wear, and I said to myself, I'm going to get that kid a nice new locket.
Thanks, Mr. Warbucks.
Thank
you very much.
So let's just take off that...
No! Paper. No, please don't make me take off my locket. I don't want a new one.
Annie, what's wrong?
This locket. My mother and father left it with me when they left me at the orphanage. There was a note, too. You're coming back for me. I know, being here with you for Christmas, I'm real lucky, but I don't know how to say it. The one thing I want in the whole world, more than anything else, is to have my real mother and father. And to be like other kids, but both of my own!
Annie, it'll be all right. I'll find them. I'll find your parents for you.
Shh, baby,
I'll get her a brandy.
It's going to be all right.
Miss Annie, you just see. If there's anyone who can find your parents, Warbucks is the man.
That's right. He'll find your mother and father if he has to pull every political string there is to pull, up to and including the White House.
The League of Nations.
If he should need me.
Annie's parents, if you're listening in, there's $50,000 and a wonderful little girl waiting for you. So get in touch right away now. You hear?
Hey, Mr. Peel, it's time for once again. Lovely.
It most certainly is, Waggy. I can tell by the chime of the clock that another one of our Thursday night get-togethers is gone by faster than you can say, Oxydent.
O-I-E-T.
The tickets of the star.
To make your teeth Hollywood bright.
So for all the Hour of Smiles family. And
Connie,
the lovely boiling sister,
Freddy the Kraken,
and Wacky,
and Dippy Dog's pretty lonely nice announcer.
Well, this is Bert Healy saying, hey, hobo man, hey, dapper Dan, you both got your style, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Savile Row is what you wear from ear to ear, and not from head to toe. That matters.
So,
Senator.
So,
Janitor.
So,
Longborough.
So,
well, brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Ready or not, here he goes. Listen to Bert tap his smiling toes.
louder.
Lovely as you sound on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, Shall we begin?
You wait outside. We'll be with you when we're done.
No, Oliver. Let Annie stay. Having a child on hand may put us at our best behavior. And Harold, I don't want to hear so much as a gosh out of you.
Franklin, a child.
And now, Oliver, since you speak for all those happy few Americans who have any money left, I'd like to hear your views on the matter.
Thank you, Mr. President. In the words of Calvin Coolidge, the business of this country is business. So for the good of you, Mr. President, this country, Wall Street, and me, we have got to get my factories open and the workers back to work.
Well, according to my latest figures, there are at least 15 million Americans out of work and 50 million more with no visible means of support.
Precisely.
Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem.
What?
The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more disturbing each day. There could be war.
Germany, hell! There are people starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but in the long run, we're not...
Cordell, when people are starving, there is no long run.
The trouble is, it's all happening at once. The stock market is taking another nosedive.
Sit down, strikes, riots,
floods, and dust storms.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Al Capone.
Yeah.
Well, at least we're all agreed on one thing. The situation is hopeless and getting worse.
Yeah. Henry, I'd like to take a look at those figures.
That son of a gun tomorrow bet your body.
Well, girl, be quiet, Harold. What was that, Annie? No, it's all right, my dear. Go ahead. It's still a free country.
Just thinking about tomorrow. Goodbye,
President.
Roosevelt, Dick.
No, thank you, Annie. You're the kind of person a president should have around him.
Mr. President, what if we created 1,000 new federal projects?
Dams?
Yes. Highways? Yes.
New post offices?
Yes. We have the unemployed to build them.
Why, we could create 5 million more jobs within 6 months.
And weekly paychecks. We'd get all those millions of leads back to paying taxes.
We could build a country so strong that nobody, including Chancellor Hitler, could ever defeat us in a war.
Mr. President, what we've got to give this country is nothing less than a new outlook.
A new vision.
A new approach.
A new culture.
A new dedication.
A new horizon.
A new spirit.
A new attitude.
A new deal.
Yes.
Yes. I was right the first time. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're only a day away.
Harmony.
Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're only a day someone but me. My speech has
those legal papers I gave you the other day?
I'll get them right away, sir.
Well, Grace, wait. I want you to stay a moment. Dance with me.
Oh!
I haven't danced since J.P. Morgan went bust. Annie, sit down. Annie, I want to adopt.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my real mother and father, there's nobody in the world I'd rather have more father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake!
Yes, sir?
Call Judge Brandeis and ask him to come over and sign those adoption papers.
Yes, sir.
Grace, Thomas, and Pew, we're going to have a house full of guests. We'll need flowers.
Flowers.
Caviar.
Caviar.
And champagne.
And champagne.
Annie, this isn't just going to be an adoption. It is going to be a celebration. And you can have anyone in the whole world come that you would like. Who do you want? Johnny Rockefeller? Babe Ruth? Adam Chiang Kai-shek? She is a lot of fun.
Well, I guess I'd like to stay out here.
That's who I'd like to. Drake!
Yes, sir?
Tell the staff to get stiffed up. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the kids!
No, it'll be way past their bedtime. But I'll tell you what, we'll have everyone from the orphanage here along for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Miss Hannigan, too. Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid!
Right.
They were sick and broke. We didn't know which way to turn. And the man offered us a chance to work on his farm up in Canada.
Well, we couldn't bring along your baby.
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
Mr. Lodges, we've seen a great number of people who claim to be Annie's parents.
Proof! I expect you'll be wanting proof. Well, here's our driver's licenses, and there's Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl, Anne Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th. That's my birthday.
It was in her note, sir.
Yes, I know it. Still.
Oh, please, sir, you gotta believe us. Oh, we just got in on the Greyhound this afternoon. First thing we did was go up to that orphanage, and the lady there said that our little baby was up here.
Oh, Annie. All the years I've dreamed of
holding her in my arms. The night Annie was left at the orphanage, her parents...
Oh, here's something you wouldn't know. On the night we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half of the silver locket around her neck.
Oh, look! She's wearing it!
And look, here's our hat. And it's a perfect fit.
Thank God, Ralph, she's our Annie.
Oh, she is. She is.
She seems to be.
If you'll pack her things, we'll be taking her.
Take her.
No.
What about the money, Mr. Mudge?
Oh, well, we don't have much, but anything you want will...
You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who can prove they're Annie's parents?
Well, no. Besides, we wouldn't want no money for Annie.
Right. We don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Cheryl, remember that pig farm up in New Jersey? The $50,000, we could buy it and afford to bring Annie up right in the country. With lots of fresh air and fresh eggs.
Fresh ham.
Fresh ham. Certified, huh?
All I gotta do is make it up to myself.
That's right. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
Yes, tomorrow morning on Christmas. That's when you can come back and pick up Annie and the check.
Oh?
Oh?
Problem?
No! What the heck do you prefer, sir? I think we should be getting back to the hotel now. Goodbye, Annie. Until tomorrow morning, then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us. Bye. Bye. Ooh. Pardon me, ladies. I mean it. Goodbye, everybody. Merry Christmas!
Wow, this is wonderful news, Annie.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Wonderful news. Annie has found her real mother and father, and they seem to be a very nice couple. Yes.
You're very lucky, Annie.
Yes. Right. I'm lucky. Just think. Pig farm.
We must celebrate, because it is Christmas Eve, and we have just had the most wonderful news in the world. To Annie Mudge!
To Annie Mudge!
Annie!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
I seem to have the same effect on everyone.
It was Annie.
Sir, that was Sir Mudge. I think I've seen him someplace before. I just can't remember where or when. But I have the strangest feeling. He's not who he says he is.
Impressions.
Frank.
I need your help.
Of course, I'll allow whatever I can do for you.
This way, please.
Thank you.
Thank you, Grace. I couldn't have done it without you. Merry Christmas, Annie. You're up early.
Yes. Well, I couldn't say hello to me, so I thought I'd just wait for him here. I guess he'll be taking me out to the country. Come and see me sometime, right?
Yes. I'll see you, Annie.
Yeah, come too.
We've been up all night, dear. We've had quite a time on this. FBI men coming and going. Annie, did you know that President Roosevelt is here?
Really?
Annie, I've got something very difficult I need to tell you. And the President is going to help me tell it to you.
Merry Christmas, President Roosevelt.
Merry Christmas, Annie. It's good to see you again.
It's good to see you too, sir.
Franklin?
Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. Through the paper and the handwriting on your note, he was able to trace the identity of your parents.
Yes. We ought to know that. Mr. and Mrs. Lodge.
No, dear. They aren't your real parents. Your real parents were David and Margaret Bennett.
David and Margaret Bennett? Where are they?
Annie.
Annie? Your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
You mean they're dead?
Yes, dear.
So, I'm an orphan after all. Like the other kids.
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes. And I guess I always knew that my folks were dead. And they loved me. And they would come back to me. So.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
And I love you too. Now, who the heck are Robert and Shirley Bush?
That girl. Who the heck are Robert and Shirley Bush?
Yes, the locket. That's your key, huh?
But the only ones that knew about the locket were us, of course, and the FBI.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan. And Miss Hannigan?
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from New York.
Miss Hannigan, I am delighted to meet you.
Thank you. And I can know anywhere. You are the Oliver Warbucks, right?
Yes. Miss Hannigan, you remember my secretary, Miss Farrell, of course.
Yeah.
And this is the President of the United States.
Sure.
Well, hi, kids. Hi, Annie. I didn't give a Christmas tree, kids.
Oh, my goodness.
Miss Warbucks, this has just come from the FBI.
Good. Honestly, John, now it all fits together.
Annie, come look at this.
Annie.
Take the picture to it again.
Show it to the President.
Mrs.
Mudd. Let them in, Drake.
With pleasure,
sir. Good morning.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, all.
Merry Christmas.
Merry, 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 merry.
Thank you, Drake.
Merry Christmas. Oh, look, Cheryl, there she is. Our little girl.
Your little girl.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Well, we don't want to be up all there, it being Christmas and all, so we'll be taking her, your suitcase?
Of course. Drake?
Oh, and, the check?
Ah, yes. The check. I've nearly forgotten. $50,000. Certified.
Certified?
Certified.
Paid to the order of Ralph Mugs.
Read it again.
Paid to the order of The Jig Is Up.
That's right! The jig is up, Daniel Francis Hannigan, otherwise known as Brewster Hannigan.
Also known as Ralph Fudge. Also known as Danny the Dick.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad.
Franklin, I believe that fraud is a federal offense and that your Secret Service men have the authority to arrest.
They certainly do, Oliver. Frank, will you turn them over?
Yes, sir.
Jack of the Halls, Father Holly, Father.
Yeah,
a little better than your ball,
so are you!
Yeah! Oh, poor luck, Oliver! I didn't do nothing
magnet is gone for good.
Yay!
And you won't have to work anymore.
Yay!
Then you'll get classes and teachers. Precious.